Do you want to use a parent-child relationship inside of a form? This is a common question that gets asked a lot on the Airtable forums and on this channel in general. People want to know how they can conditionally filter the information that shows up on their form. Well, if that's of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Hey, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth Pronovost. I'm the owner at Gap Consulting, where we help you to organize and automate more of your business. If that's of interest and you want to learn more about how we do that, check out the links below this video and don't miss our upcoming live webinar training. I do this live training once every week and I showcase how you can leverage automation to save up to 20 hours per person in your business. So if that's of interest, do check out that webinar link and sign up for the next training. Even if you can't attend live, you will get a copy of the recording, so no problem there. But without further ado, let's jump into the heart of this video. We're talking about using conditional dependencies inside of a form. So first, let's start off with an Airtable database structure. Maybe this will help paint the picture and help us visualize what we're trying to get at. I've got three businesses inside of my database: Acme, Apple, and Google. And then I've got a bunch of different addresses here as well. Now, these addresses are specific to a business. So if I group by businesses here, you can see that, sure enough, we've got at least two addresses for two of our businesses and then only one address for another. And so the idea is, well, wouldn't it be cool if we had a form and then, you know, somebody said, hey, I'm here representing Apple. I'm filling this information out on behalf of Apple. And then the next question in the form was, okay, well, what address then are we sending this order to? And it knew automatically, well, if they're from Apple, then it has to be one of these two addresses. Or it knew, well, if they're from Acme, then of course they should only be able to see this address to be selected, right? So this is using that parent-child relationship inside the form where we say, we know the address relates to the business. We want to display this information, right? And only that information that is linked appropriately to that parent record. In this case, the business is the parent record. The address is the child record that relates to the business. So we have a linked relationship here as well to the people. And this is a great thing because we can then use that information as well in our form. We know that if we're sending something, for example, to 7788 Apple Street, well, then it should be made out in attention C Apple. So let's talk about how we can do this in a form. But before we get to the fun advanced stuff, let's talk about why the simple approach just really isn't a good answer. So if I were to build an online form like this, sure, I could put a drop-down box here and I could limit the option for what is the business, right? And then I could put a drop-down box for what is the address here. But there's no way for us to limit the address options inside of the form. Yes, we can build awesome conditional logic with forms, and Jotform and other form tools make that really, really easy to use. But we cannot conditionally impact the options available unless we use an advanced parent-child relationship. And this is something that is entirely unique to Jotform as a form solution. So my honest recommendation, if you're using Airtable as your backend database and you need a more advanced form than the Airtable form permits, I think the best option out there is Jotform for this specific reason, because what I'm about to show you here is unavailable to any other form software. This is something that was built by On2Air. You've probably heard of them if you follow within the Airtable community. They do a lot of work in this space, but one of the things that they do is offer some add-on tools. And what we're going to look at today is one of those things. So if you don't already have an On2Air account, I will include a link below. Full disclosure, this is an affiliate link. So if you want to throw a little support to the channel, it's not going to cost you anything extra, but it's a great way for you to say thank you for the content. So using that link or just going to On2Air, you're going to see a similar situation to this. Now, the first thing you need to do is go into your settings once you've signed up. I'm going to go ahead and open this in a new tab. And you'll need to build your first connection to an app. And so in this case, we need to integrate to Jotform, right? And so in order to do that, just click this plus button and tell it what software you want to connect to. Now I'm going to go back to my other page And here I am on the Jotform forms. Now, if you are having problems negotiating this, all you need to do is, from the home screen, click on Forms. It's going to get you into here, and you'll need to set up your first connection. Now, I've already done that here, but let's go through it together again. We're going to connect a form, and here we're going to see our Jotform connection. This is using the API connection that we just established. Then we can select the form from a list. If we have a number of forms, we'll see them all here. And we can give it an internal name and create that form. Now, once we're inside of that, let's drop into the form itself. And you're going to see that we have some advanced options now that are going to appear on our Jotform once we establish them here. So again, let's go back to my Jotform and remember that I have these three placeholder example fields here. Now, we're going to wind up replacing these, but let's go ahead and add some more advanced fields. So we actually want to talk to Airtable and pull in Airtable data into our form, right? So let's go ahead and create a new field. And the first one we're going to start with is a select field. We have these three options, but the select field is going to pull information directly from Airtable, and that's what we want. So we're going to go ahead and select this, and we're going to need to add a configuration here. We need to build an Airtable connection. Since we don't have that yet, we're going to need to first set up the API. So again, let's go up to Settings, open in a new tab, and here is the ability to integrate with Airtable. Now I have an integration to both Jotform and Airtable, so I can get them talking, and OntoAir is going to act as the glue between those two pieces of software. So going back into my form setup, I'll refresh my page. I can now make a selection, and I see that I have that new Airtable connection. Now I need to tell it what the Airtable database is, so I can map to that database. I've called mine Conditional Dependencies Form Example. I make that selection, tell it what table I want to look at. In this case, I'm looking at the businesses table. That's the first question on my form. What business do you represent? I'll make that selection, and you can limit it to a view if you'd like. In my case, I'm going to skip that, and I'll come down to the next required piece. These are some more advanced features. If you want to put some more advanced things into it, you can also include a search configuration. But in my example, I'm going to just go for that display configuration down to the next required field, and I need to tell it how I want this information to show up in my form. It's going to give me the options of the fields that are in that database table. So again, going back into my businesses table in Airtable, I have a name, and then I have the address that's linked to these businesses. So of course, in my case, I want to go with the name as the display field. And that's it. I have completely filled out all of the needs for this. I will update my field details, and I'm good to go. Now, if I flip back into Jotform and I refresh my form page, now that element appeared down here in my form. I can change it to what business, and I can remove my old form element that included the different businesses, and I can relocate this one and put it at the top of my form. Now let's go ahead and publish this and look at the actual live version of the form. Now the cool part about this is it's going to load results that are actually inside of my Airtable database. So these are the example companies that show up in my database, and that information is showing up here on my form. All right, now we want to add an address to our form, but we want that address to be limited based on addresses for the business that was picked in our form. So this is where we're going to get into the more advanced stuff. So let's go back into our OntoAir setup. Back here, I'm going to drill back into my form. This is my conditional dependencies form example, and we just built this new select field. Now, something we didn't include the first time we did this, we're going to have to make a slight adjustment to our first field before we build our subfield that pulls the child relationship from our first question. So let's drill back into our new select field details, and we're going to go ahead and update the details here. Now you'll want to scroll down to the display configuration settings. And what you need to do here is make sure that on the second question for value fields, that we're passing information through to the next stage of the form. So remember, the first question in our form is, what's the business? Well, we need to take that business and do something with it in the next question addresses. We need to know what the business is. It needs to be passed through to the next stage. So in order to do this, we need to make sure that we're passing that information along. So if this is X'd out and you don't pass any information on into the next stages of the form, you're not going to be able to drive that conditional dependency. So again, make sure that you've got the name getting passed along here and save or update those settings. Now we can go into the next part of this and set up the next section. So I'm going to drill back into my forms, go into my particular form here, and I'm going to add a new field. I'm going to add the subselect field, and this is where we are going to build that conditional dependency based on the business. So let's add our configuration here. We just set it up like we did the first one, new Airtable connection, select the base. They have a nice little search feature there, so you can just start typing the base name. Select the table. In this case, I want to display the address. And then we can also make a selection to the view, although it's not required. We're going to scroll down and look at the next required field. Now, if you want to alter the way the search configuration shows up, you can apply a sorting or whatever you'd like, but I'm going to skip that. I'm going to come down to the display configuration, and the part that I want to show is the address, right? And so I'm going to make that selection. So the full address here. And if you want the select fields to be available for other fields, this is the question that we just had to go back and fix for our first select. Well, maybe I want to pass along the attention link, for example. So you can bring that in here as well. Then scrolling down a little bit further, we'll see the next piece that we have to fill out is the parent source. In this case, it is a select field. And I will tell it what select field. Well, that's the select field that we already got earlier in our form. And what's the parent source? Well, it's the name, okay? There has to be an exact match to the name of the business that was supplied in the first question in order for us to conditionally alter or filter the list of addresses. That's what we're saying here. We're looking for a field match. What type of match? We're looking for an exact match. And select the field from this item to match with the parent value. That is the business name. So the link in our address table that connects to business needs to match the business that we selected in the first question. This is the way to set this all up. This looks right, so I'm going to update these field settings. Now I can pop back into Jotform and simply refresh my form. And I'm now going to have that address question here. I'll fill it out properly. I will delete my old one, my placeholder, and I'll move my new question up into the second spot of my form and let it go. Once we're all set here, I can go back into my form and just refresh the published version of the form and let's see if it works. So now I'm going to say what business, and when I make a selection, if I set this up appropriately, I'm only going to get the options for that particular business. And sure enough, Apple, when I select Apple, I only get the Apple street addresses. If I make a change up here and say Google, well then, suddenly, I only get to select those Google street. And lastly, if I go into Acme to check that, you'll see that I also only get Acme. So here it is. We've built a conditional dependency inside of our form. It's a really cool solution. And as I noted, you can also pass extra information along. So if you wanted to add the attention portion, that is the last part of our relationship here, because when we make a selection for an address, we know who that should be going to. Well, you can certainly add that into your form as well by using this widget as well. So I think you can see how this would really make your forms a lot more advanced. And again, this is the reason that I went with Jotform when there were a bunch of different form options out there. The fact that it has this unique integration to Airtable means that it has a feature and a function that I've never seen in another form tool. And conditional dependencies are a big ask for a lot of our clients. I hope you received a ton of value from this video. If you did, be sure to give this a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and do check those links below if you need any more help. In the meantime, I'll see you in the next video. As always, I hope you found that to be extremely helpful. If you did and you'd like to learn more, swing by our website and see how we can help. We offer a free Airtable crash course that will help you level up in Airtable quickly, and we also have some paid services, including hourly consultations with our experts. We have some online courses and a group coaching program. And for advanced needs, we can build a bespoke solution for you from scratch. So swing on by, and I look forward to connecting with you soon.